Yo, 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 what up, fam? I love doing these. Welcome back, Accounting for Beginners, my classic series, number 31. Accounting for Beginners, number 31. We here, boy. If this is your first one, hit subscribe and looking for the card up here because it's the best accounting playlist on YouTube, on the internet, in the world. Let's go. This is highly requested. So 31, it's gonna be the adjusting entries. In the book that I have here, in the book, this is the book I'm rocking with. I got it like $10 off Amazon. I don't know. 5 different adjusting entries, and we're just gonna go through them this video and the next 4, I guess. We're gonna do the adjusting entries. Yo, here they are. I've been listening, here they are. Just something I noticed out of the 5 adjusting entries, and why are they adjusting? You do it at the end of the period. You need to make adjusting entries. And why are they adjusting? Like, why do you have to wait till the end? And my opinion here is because there's no cash. Now, I could be wrong when I make statements. And anyways, I'm just a dude, man. I'm just a dude, okay? Yeah, yes, I do have a CPA license. Yes, I do this for a living. But I can make errors, sure. So there's no cash, so that's why like if there was cash in the account, then you would just be done. Like, you wouldn't need to adjust anything. You'll kind of see. So we're gonna do depreciation. It's one of the 5. Now, I've already done depreciation, but that was when I started. Is when I was first renting my office here, and I was like so nervous. I thought, you know, oh, everyone's gonna hear me, and I wasn't. And I'm like, I'm renting an office here, and I'm wasting my time making YouTube videos. No one's watching. What am I doing with my life? So, anyways, that's gonna be the first in our adjusting entries, depreciation. It's the end of the period. If you're new here, you're gonna notice this. It's a DCA blurs, kind of my mapping system. It's debit, credit, asset, draw, expense, liability, equity, revenue. I just always put that on my paper. You put that on your paper too. Don't be lazy, man. Don't be lazy. Seriously, don't be lazy. So let's set it up. Let's set it up here. During the year, and I'm gonna use the book example. During the year, you bought an asset. You bought office equipment for $1,800. You might have done that a couple years ago, but that's the only thing on the books. That's on the books. This is your balance sheet. Balance sheet is assets equal liability plus equity. The only thing on your balance sheet is you have an office equipment for $1,800. Assets equal, you don't have any liabilities, and your equity is $1,800 equity of the office equipment. You already used cash when you bought this. You have debit office equipment, credit cash, and so that was a journal entry to get this on the books. It was money coming out, and you put it on as an asset. So what is depreciation anyways? Let's say office equipment. Let's say this is a printer. It's an $1,800 printer that's going to last for a long time. You have it on as an asset. You spent money over here, and now you have an asset for that, for the office equipment, for the printer. Now, because that's going to last for years, so you're going to expense it every year. Let's say you bought paper for the printer. Now, you're going to run through that in a couple months. So, yes, you have cash coming out for that, but you're just going to expense it right now because you're going to use it in less than a year or the period. When you're buying an asset, or I guess buying something and using it as an expense, that's going to be your debit. It's either going to be the asset, it's going to be the office equipment, the printer, or the paper. So it's always gonna, and your credit's going to be money leaving. That's going to be your credit. So a year has gone by, and now you're like, well, you know, we have less time on this printer, and we need to do our expense for the year, and that is a depreciation expense. So what would the journal entry be? It's always about a journal entry. What's the journal entry going to be? Hopefully went over that, so you would think, well, now we need to expense the journal entry. We need to expense this printer because it's been on the books for a year. Depreciation expense. Also, you might just hear You might just have heard just in life, you know, depreciation expense, depreciation expense, depreciation. You don't really know anything, or you know some, I don't know. So depreciation, we've gone over this, you're like, I've heard depreciation expense, I know DCA LER, so probably it's probably gonna be right there. I'm gonna write the journal entry here. Depreciation expense, $50, because we figured out through everything that we're gonna depreciate this office equipment $50 for the year. And now we gotta journalize it, or the period. So we know, well, we're taking a really good guess because we're not a professional. We haven't done this a million times yet, so we don't really know. But we're just going to take a guess, and we're going to say debit is going to be $50 depreciation expense. All right, great. Now, we need a credit now. We need a credit. And we know it's got to be 50 bucks because they always equal. So look, we have no idea about much. We've heard depreciation expense and we know DCA LER, so look at all the stuff we're getting right already. Step by step by step, practice, practice, practice. So we're gonna put $50 over here in the credit. Now here's where it gets a little tricky. And you just gotta know what is gonna be the credit. It's a thing called accumulated depreciation. And it's called a contra asset, meaning it's an asset, but it's a negative asset. You just gotta know, I think for now, when you have depreciation expense, the credit for it is an accumulated depreciation. Okay, so that's the journal entry for a depreciation. Is debit $50 depreciation expense, credit accumulated depreciation. See, now look, there's no money, no cash involved in this because you already bought the asset before. So now we're just depreciating the asset. So this is your expense now. Do you see, like, if you for the year, because like when you bought paper or supply, you expensed it right away. But now you're getting expense. You still want to show here that you bought the office equipment for $1,800 on the balance sheet. See, it's a contra asset, meaning it is a credit. See, so it's over here. Accumulated depreciation is a credit. And as you can see, it would be if it's an asset, accumulated depreciation is an asset because it goes along with the fixed assets. It would be negative over here, and that's in its normal balance, negative on the credit side. So that's why it's contra. So it goes here as a negative. And on the balance sheet, you would have accumulated depreciation for $50. That's what on the balance sheet. So then your office equipment's worth $1,750 now. Thank you for watching. Thank you very much. If you enjoyed it, get a like. And I'm under this new method of I'm just trying to put out more content and let you decide if it's good. I know it's not perfect. And I'm sorry for that. I'm trying to get better every time. Until next time, stay blessed. Love y'all. Peace.